Ladies and gents, guys and gals, I want you to understand that the majority of us get anxious when we are exposed to something new. Think about your first day on the job. What did you feel? Perhaps excitement from starting a new job, mixed with some anxiety from being in a new place with many new people you don't know, performing tasks that may also be new to you. The point is, the main reason a person will completely reject an idea is because it scares them. Take flat earth, for example. Now, I've looked into this topic extensively for a long time, and I cannot find anything conclusive. It's just another theory, but that's okay. I'm not afraid of it. I'm just not content with the evidence. Understand, folks, these days, you are going to be exposed to many new beliefs, ideas, concepts, and theories that go against your current beliefs, ideas, concepts, and theories. Some of these things are going to be shocking, but this will train you to question things, something that people are not doing enough of. With that said, I'm going to talk about something that is controversial. Now, you can either reject the information, but you never, ever just accept it. You need to learn how to question everything that is presented to you. So grab your sunglasses and pull up a chair as we take an alternative look at our sun. In order for one theory to beat another, it has to make more sense than the other one, not less sense. And of course, there needs to be better evidence presented to support the theory. This occurs often in the scientific community, and you all know it. They tell you something is one way 30 years ago, and today it's changed. What is this, the Mandela effect? Why didn't anyone take the time out to question the matter then? The sun, ladies and gentlemen, is not what you think it is. How do I know this? Because they truly do not know what's inside it. They have a pretty good idea, but it's not anything close to what you're probably thinking of. So, they have picked an idea that most people would agree with, and that's it. Now, they do this for mainly two reasons. One, to hide the truth. Two, to make money. The most profitable, most powerful, and most corrupted industry in the world is that of consumable energy. We have all been bred with this belief that something needs to be ignited and burned to produce the massive amounts of energy that we use each day. Think about it. We've gotten way past the stage of the combustible engine, but everybody is still driving cars that have them. People love spending money on gas. They don't trust anything else. They can't. It's been ingrained into their subconscious. And anytime anyone comes out with something more efficient, that person's got problems. Believe it. This industry has the game down tight. They know exactly what they're doing and how to do it. And they have you convinced that nuclear fusion is the most powerful way to produce energy. After all, that's how the sun works. Or that's what they will have you believe. You have your hydrogen deuterium atom, which consists of one proton and one neutron. If you add another hydrogen proton, you get helium-3, which has two protons, but still one neutron. You take two of these helium-3 atoms and combine them, you get helium-4. This fusion of atoms releases an incredible amount of energy. However, you need a tremendous amount of energy to cause this to happen. You also need a vacuum and a strong magnetic gravitational force to keep the hot plasma confined. But once the candle is lit, it burns for quite some time. This is what they tell us about what the sun is doing. And it makes sense. However, the only observable nuclear fusion that occurs is on the sun's surface in the arcs, the discharge. The sun being a thermonuclear reactor with a hot core is just a theory, like everything else. And they certainly don't know what's inside it. It's just like the tree stump theory. People settle on a science and accept certain ideas because it allows them not to have to look any further into it. The scientific community honestly does not fully understand what the sun is, or light for that matter. They don't even fully understand light. Some say the sun works by cold fusion, which opens up a whole new world of possibilities. Some say it's electrical energy, which, if you do a little searching, makes a lot of sense as well. There are a lot more theories out there than that, folks. I don't have time to sit here and make these things up. If I had that type of imagination, I would be writing movies and screenplays for NASA. Speaking of NASA, what I am going to say may not blow your mind, but it may twist it a little. The electromagnetic radiation, the frequencies given off by the sun, are invisible. It is only when it is filtered or absorbed by our atmosphere that you get visible light. The same rule applies for being able to see the sun. You can only see the sun with your eyes because of the absorption of frequencies by our atmosphere. So the question is, how do you see the sun and the stars in space? Go take a look at the ISS live feed. Now, this is a network of several cameras on the space station. HD cameras. If you go to a location on Earth that has very little light pollution, at night you can see that the sky is teeming with stars. However, on this live feed, I haven't been able to spot a single star in the background. Am I crazy? What? Is the Earth and the sun too bright? Shouldn't that background be littered with stars? It seems interesting as well to see that they need to sell the fact that it's the space station by showing a part of the station in the shot along with the astronauts themselves. And they certainly do make sure they get the sun in the shot. They now have HD footage of the sun up close. How do they get this footage? What kind of cameras and filters are they using to get this type of image? I'm not saying this is fake, but it does arouse questions. It seems that NASA spends a lot of time and money studying the sun, and now they want to send probes there. Why? I mean, if the sun is as hot as they say it is, then how close could they possibly get to it? Now, I'm going to give you something to think about. We should all have an understanding of what black holes are in space. They are areas in space that have such a strong gravitational pull that nothing, not even light, can escape it. The result of a collapsed star at the end of its life, they say. Or could it be that a black hole is a star inside out? And a star is a black hole inside out. This would make the sun hollow, because the sun really just converts energy from nowhere. I'm sure you may have seen images or videos of what appears to be something going into and coming out of the sun. Could the sun be an actual stargate? That's a whole other video, and I'm sure NASA has an explanation for this. I don't know what's real anymore, folks. I do my best to keep myself healthy, safe, and alive. But in order for us to move forward as people, we're going to need to break through the lies and get to the bottom of things. It's the only way to break free from the madness.